Is Black Ops 4 Zombies good? I don't know. Personally, I love me some BO4 Zombies, but we're going to be individually reviewing the maps right now, and we're going to see how you guys feel, because it's been almost three years, and you know, Black Ops 4 was one of the most hated Zombies games of all time, and I just want to know, is it really that bad, or did we take it for granted? So the first map we're going to be reviewing is Voyage of Despair. There is not much to talk about for this one, in my opinion. This is the weakest map in the game. Unfortunately, we're not starting off strong here. But the Easter egg is a train wreck. Lining up the planets is a train wreck. The wonder weapons are cool. The map layout is so vertical and disgusting. I really don't like it. There's not much good things to say about Voyage of Despair, and I'm sorry for that. But I'll give it a 4 out of 10. I just want to get that one done quick, because it's just not good, and it's not making me look good because I'm trying to make BO4 look good. So the next map we have is 9. 9 was fantastic. I mean, the spawn room is like the middle of the map, which is such a cool idea. And then you have the 4 perks that branch off from the spawn room, and also directly under the spawn room is Pack-a-Punch. This map layout just makes sense. The only knock I have of this map, like really honestly, the only thing I do not like about this map is it's so easy. It's such a simple layout, but it's cool and it works. And this is like a great beginner map for Black Ops 4. Voyage of Despair is this complicated fuckfest, but 9 works. 9 is a great wonder weapon, good Easter egg quest. Even though it's annoying, you have to start at 17, but I give 9 an 8 out of 10. The next map, Classified. I love me some Classified. I won't play it now because I burnt myself out. But when this game came out, high rounding, using the Winter's Howl, the overall just, you know, Easter egg steps, Project Scatty is cool. The high round Easter egg's cool and innovative. The shield strat with Victoria's Tortoise is awesome. And I just love the fact that we get to play as Ultimus at the Pentagon. I think this is absolutely incredible. And I always love this map. I'm giving it Classified another 8 out of 10. And now we have Blood of the Dead. My boy, Blood of the Dead. I love me some Blood of the Dead. This is the best storyline map of all time. I don't care what anybody says. This is the most emotional I will get over a Zombies map or a story. So we have a very, very good storyline map. We have a good Easter egg quest, in my opinion. I know people hate this Easter egg quest, and that is totally okay. But the intro and the outro cutscenes are two of the best we have ever seen, and I love the changes they made to Mob of the Dead. Mob of the Dead was not the best layout, and I just love that they added a whole nother island. I know it seems counterintuitive, and you have to fast travel, and it feels like you're running a marathon running across the map, but I respect Treyarch for trying something new here. I love the premise story. I love the Blundergat upgrades. I love the Easter egg quest. I'm a sicko. I love this map. I know people hate this map. Blood of the Dead, 9 out of 10. DLC one time, baby. Dead of the Night. All right, Dead of the Night is one of those maps that is fantastic, but I never personally enjoyed. This is kind of a personal enjoyment, but it's also a ranking of just the map and how good it is. I truly believe Voyage of Despair is a dog shit map. I truly believe Dead of the Night is a very good map, but I just never gave myself the opportunity or time to get into it. I know it has a great Easter egg quest. I love this wonder weapon. The vibe of this map is so cool. This mansion. The cons. All right, let's get into the cons. It's a prequel. That's some bullshit. It has the strangest cast. Is this a celebrity cast? I think it is, but it didn't really work in my opinion. The celebrity cast was not the best idea. Don't have much to say about this map. The Nosferatu's suck. The boss fight's fun. The werewolves are cool. The silver bullets are cool. 7 out of 10. Dead of the Night's alright. Now we have Ancient Evil. Change the landscape of BO4 Zombies. Because up until Ancient Evil, BO4 Zombies was pretty wonky. Because, you know, it didn't really release with a good build. It was crashing a lot. The maps were very annoying to get, you know, to know at first. This game was just a mess. I'm not saying the maps before were bad. I'm just saying the launch and everything that had to do with this game was a complete mess up until this point. Ancient Evil, 4 elemental wonder weapons, the finale to the Chaos storyline, a great map layout. The fucking gauntlets are so good. We're in Greece. There's a Pegasus. There's a Zombies Warlord. There's fucking Medusa. There's a new shield, finally. This map is so good. It is so good. It is a top 5 Zombies map of all time. Incredible boss fight, incredible map layout, timeless memories, an Easter egg hunt that actually lasted pretty long and everyone was stuck on the last step for a little while. This map is fantastic. Fuck you if you don't enjoy it. If you don't enjoy this map, your opinion's invalid. I'm sorry. I still love you. Thanks for watching. If you're here and you hate Ancient Evil,
10 out of 10. I don't care. I love this map to death. The next map we have is Alpha Omega, one of the most polarizing maps of Call of Duty Zombies history. We have a Nuketown Zombies remake, and a lot of people love Nuketown Zombies. I mean, like, the Smith Place, Q Knights, these zombies YouTubers or old-time zombies YouTubers, I remember them loving Nuketown. I always enjoyed Nuketown. It's a fun little challenge map, and Alpha Omega is the perfect remaster. This map just has so much emotional storyline weight to it. This is fucking it. We're nearing the finale. We're nearing the Great War. We're playing as both of the crews at once. We're returning to Nuketown. We finally get to see the bunker and the shelter, and Marlton's in a door. This is everything we've asked for from Treyarch, and then when we get it, we complain? Like, come on, guys. Like, this map is so cool. The new Nova Crawler is so cool. The entire theme of this map, the round change music, the boss fight music, the turning on the power music, it's just like this beautiful 8-bit. It's just so good. This map is thematically beautiful. And guess what? Guess what? The boss fight is the electric dude. The Avogadro comes back one more time. And the wonder weapons are 4 elemental Mark IIs. Yes, you could say this is lazy, but I think it's so cool. Alpha Omega is one of the most underrated zombies maps of all time. 9 out of 10. I don't care. Now it's Togger Toten. Fuck this map. 1 out of 10. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I love all of you. Let me know if I changed your opinions on any Black Ops 4 maps today. And yeah, I'll see y'all later. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out.